that we usually seek to take the edge off. Our feelings about the human condition can be complicated. Well, we do have a whole book that can help us face off with this test, even if it feels like a book that we haven't quite yet cracked open. It's a whole book of love, in fact, and I realize every time I come back to it that I know so very little about it, even though I have thumbed through the pages on occasion. Lucky for me, for all of us, God knew the story cover to cover. He foresaw the whole course from the beginning, and instead of despising us for blowing the whole thing off, God drew near to us in love through Jesus Christ to help us with these lessons that love asks us to take up. God came to guide us through the tests, great and small. And without that mercy, we should all fail entirely. Jesus, though, as we heard in the gospel just now, passes his testing and temptation with flying colors. I always was envious of those kids in the class. But the good news of today's gospel is that we don't have to be worried. We have as much help as we need right there on offer to help us through, even if it will sometimes feel challenging. Jesus' time of temptation was a test that lifted up for all of us the miracle that God works on our behalf when we trust and obey the wisdom of love. No, it's not a cheat sheet exactly, chock full of formulas, but the Bible does hold all the salient details that we need to cooperate with love's saving grace. Just before his time of temptation, we didn't get to hear it this morning, but Jesus is at his baptism, right before the Spirit sends him out into the wilderness, and if you recall, God is shouting all over the place, dive-bombing him with the Holy Spirit, saying, "This is my Son, the Beloved, in whom I am well pleased." Maybe that's still ringing in his muscle memory as he shouts down with the devil in the desert. I think we too can bask in love's power to uphold and protect us as we face our own times of temptation and testing. As Jesus faced off with the tempter, divine wisdom was his lifeline. Jesus summoned all those words that he knew and loved, words from the Torah, God's law of love that revealed everything that love commands. Those wise words Jesus committed to memory, they were powerful. They helped him see through that devil's twisting of the truth. They gave him the power to just say no. I wonder, do we know God's word that way? Does the Bible's wisdom shape our lives? I think Scripture can equip us to take on those personal and communal seasons of challenge and temptation. In fact, if you were here on Wednesday for the Ash Wednesday liturgy, you heard that classic exhortation that the Church, for many centuries, has admonished the faithful in Lent to engage Scripture in our daily lives. So how could we begin? This morning, there was a group that met in Higby Library just before the service. We usually gather around 9:10 and finish up about 9:45. We're unpacking the stories from Scripture that we encounter in worship on Sundays. You'd be welcome to join us next week. If you're more independent or your schedule's a little challenging, a do-it-yourself format will work just fine. 20 minutes or less a day. If you're an auditory learner, technology makes listening easy. Yes, there's an app for that, but as I heard Beth reading Romans, I wanted to say, can you please read Scripture to me out loud? I love how you bring it to life, and Romans is a tough book for that. Yes, this good book wants dusting off, and we can help each other as we try to lean in and let its go through that time of trouble, it shall not overwhelm you. I'm sure you have your own favorites. And it's okay if nothing comes to mind. The book is chock full of examples, plenty to go around. Jesus' words are a powerful place to start. The Psalms, they're ready-made scriptural prayers. And then there's also the meaty material in all of Paul's letters to fellow Christians. Exploring with friends, people we know, people here, scholars that we don't, can give us insights into the diverse languages in which these words of divine love are spoken. Lately, I've been loving this book by Richard Rohr, entitled Things Hidden, Scripture as Spirituality. Rohr is contemplative, and he's also very practical. He's been preaching and unpacking the wisdom of our tradition, the wisdom of God given down through the apostles, down through the scriptures for many years. Even as he draws to the close of his own life, there's so much wisdom that he wants to share. As we approach these books of the Bible that aren't just always easy to decipher, we know that we do it from different, vastly different cultural and historical locations than the people who were originally the hearers of that word. And these kinds of scholarly tools can aid our understanding so that we can train our ears to hear God's languages of love. This morning, it was pretty impressive seeing Jesus' savvy with these saving words of the Torah. Love's liberating power was shouting in him. And love strengthens us also to meet the challenges that we will face and to resist temptations that all of us will encounter. Love helps us trust more and more in the Holy One, the God who calls us to live differently, to lead lives of sacrificial love. And love steadies us, because we will fall short, we will fail, and we will have opportunity to repent and return to God whenever we step away from love's graces. That's what this season of Lent is all about. It's not about thinking that we're awful humans. It's about seeing love's presence with us always, inviting us back, drawing us, giving us the strength to return. Tempted to turn stones into bread, Jesus pulls out words of providence to nourish his soul and body with God's wisdom. Words from the mouth of God. That's quite an image that we get to read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, like our prayer book says. Tested and tempted to push against divine promises of protection by throwing himself off the temple in a reckless stunt, Jesus confidently insists there is wisdom in divine limits. I wonder if that would hold some wisdom for us. Tempted by the devil's false pretense of power, bow down and worship me, and I will share all these amazing things with you. Jesus says, nah. He harnesses and wraps himself up in words of humility, redirecting his life and his loves towards God's purposes and God's timing. How did Jesus do this? Yes, the story says he quoted scripture at the devil. Maybe it wasn't an incantation, but it was a way of reminding himself of the truth that he knew deep in his bones. God's words were instilled in Jesus since his childhood. God's commandments grounded his whole way of loving to sharing their gifts of love when Jesus was around got to be part of the miracles that he multiplied. We too can participate in this magnificent life of love. Moments of testing will arise, but they need not be a nightmare. The word of God and the way of love will free us from fear and help us to resist those desires that distance and distract us from the faithful lives that we are called to lead through the wisdom and power of the Holy Spirit, as Jesus teaches us everything that love commands.